And today, the State Department of Public Health reporting a sharp increase in the number of coronavirus cases. 3,059 new cases have been reported in the last day, but it comes as the state reported near record levels of testing. 32 more people lost their lives to the virus, bringing the total death toll to 8,910. Statewide positivity rate continued to climb, ticking up again to 3.7%.
Which brings us to the medical watch. The question is, which COVID test should you get?
Yeah, there are some differences you need to know about. Mm-hmm. Medical reporter Dina Baer has more on reliability, accuracy, and speed.
Some tests look for the DNA of the virus. Others look to see if your body is waging a war against the virus and therefore producing antigens. One takes time, the other is rapid. And doctors say speed isn't always the most sound choice.
So we do have a need for rapid, easily administered tests in this country as we try to, go about our daily business.
There is value in a rapid test for large events or medical procedures when there is a need to know immediately. But speed sacrifices accuracy.
The rapid tests in general tend to be less sensitive. And so, as is the case with any type of COVID testing, it's important to be cautious, wear masks, continue to social distance, because it's possible to get a false negative result, as we're seeing in this country.
Abbott insists its antigen screen identifies positive test results 95% of the time and renders a negative result in 97.9% of samples. But doctors in the heart of COVID units treating patients say in their experience, the rapid 30-minute tests made by multiple manufacturers are only 70% sensitive in accurately identifying SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19. And when patients are tested too early, when viral levels are low, it may give a false negative.
It's important to recognize that a test is really a snapshot in time of that patient. And we have certainly had patients who tested negative, were symptomatic, and were retested, some days later and became positive. We just had caught them too early on the first sampling of that patient.
Walking around with a false sense of security may lead some to unknowingly spread COVID-19. And it is important to seek out testing if exposed to this coronavirus. Multiple testing options make that easier. Some places are doing what seem to be more comfortable testing as opposed to the deep nasal approach. But the risks may outweigh the benefits.
The gold standard test is still going to be a deep nasal swab, a nasopharyngeal swab, followed up by PCR testing. That is the best sensitivity and specificity that we can offer anywhere in the world. However, it's difficult to administer those swabs. It's less comfortable for patients, so many locations are now doing less deep or anterior nary swabs. The sensitivity is a little bit less because we're not collecting as much virus on those types of samples as you would get from a nasopharyngeal swab.
Throat swabs are also now available.
Similarly, there's been a lot in the news lately about saliva testing. And again, saliva is a sample that we can then use by whatever analytical means we use in the laboratory. A little less sensitive, most likely, but obviously easier to collect, and it doesn't necessarily need a well-trained medical professional and complete personal protective equipment. So there are some advantages to that. But again, understand that the trade-off is perhaps a little bit of sensitivity in detecting the virus.
At North Shore University Health System, Dr. Karen Call leads a team that runs about 2,000 tests a day. She knows the importance of accuracy.
In the hospital setting, the last thing we wanted was someone coming in with an unexpected COVID that could spread it around the hospital. So we've been very cautious in a hospital setting to use the most sensitive test possible.
Bottom line, if you want to do what the medical professionals do for testing, go with the deep nasal swab PCR test. Back to you.